City of Lowndes is a rezoning request by tree lawn companies to rezone 4.48 acres from conditional office professional to residential professional without conditions. That's an MOP conditional to RP with no conditions. Such property is currently vacant. It is located at 2320 North Patterson Street. You see on the map on the screen, it's at the corner of North Patterson and Roosevelt, and directly across the street from Southwood Medical Center, the inside of their campus where you find the parking lot. Subject property is currently split zone. As you see, it's OP and RP. That RP on the western side of the acreage is RP conditional. There's been a long history in the past 15 years of different zoning changes, different development proposals. All of that is outlined there on the cover page of the packet. That RP conditional was for a proposed apartment building. You will remember that from, I think, the year 2016. There was a four-story apartment building just in that back area. The rest was to remain as office park. The applicant is different this time. It's part of the original group of developers, but they're looking at doing additional multifamily than what was contemplated in 2016. OP, like we talked about in the work session, does not allow multifamily, so it is a downzoning to RP to allow some of that multifamily development to come forward. In your pack, of course, is the maps and zoning pattern. There we go. Character areas, institutional activity center, which is the area around Southbrook Medical Center and the north campus of BSU. Aerial imagery, you see the rooftops of the large buildings nearby, the vacant land that is the subject property, and a couple buildings to the rear. Boundary survey more closely shows you how the split zoning runs through the property. That north-south thin line is a zoning boundary line. It is not a property line. It simply separates the two areas of the different zoning classifications. Track number three is the existing office building. That was built originally in speculation purposes on the back portion of this property. It still remains. And then the subject property from Patterson looks like this. An open green lawn and a forest of pine trees. And then the existing building in the back. Notice this is adjacent property. It is not subject property, but it is part of the proposed development. The office building will remain as an office building. The proposed apartments will go around it. This is the Valdosta Lounge Development Authority building, which was parceled out, I think, in the year 2011. And then across the street on the other side of Patterson with the BSU North Campus buildings, and then the parking deck at Southbrook Medical Center. But this is the more interesting diagram. It shows the proposed apartments as a four-story building that wraps around a pool courtyard. You see the back segment of apartments that is in the existing RP zoning, which is that wing that's surrounded by trees on two sides. The rest of it is in the OP zoning area, and that's hence the rezoning request. Proposed to be 117 dwelling units, which is the maximum density allowed in RP zoning on this property. You see parcels labeled as future development, presumably some type of office or mixed use on those parcels. They do not know yet what those might look like, but they have an apartment building design ready to go, and that's what they're wanting to start. This building has, with all its changes over 15 years, has been sitting dormant a long time. Staff particularly is glad to see something moving forward. With that, some other detail in your packet of floor plans. This is the first floor. Showing you different types of apartments, and it's a mixture of what looks to me is one bedroom, two bedroom, and also efficiency apartments. Some amenity space that you see there in green. Second floor is similar. And then third and fourth floors are identical and look like this. Elevation drawings in your packet. Modern design building, resembling more of an office type building than a typical residential, although lots of balcony space. The very interesting facade that's there. This is in the urban commercial corridor overlay district, which requires some facade articulation on the property and may more than meet for the number of requirements for this. Going quickly through. fairly attractive building for this part of the property. So with that, staff is recommending approval of the zoning change from conditional OP to RP for this property. Glad to answer any questions that you might have.
Matt, I'm just curious, when we did that four years ago, was that time, that timetable for Mark to start that project? And I'm just curious.
There's no time. It was going to start that year. It was a rezoning, so there was no plan development or expiration dates. It was conditional RP. Those conditions are there in your packet. There is time to protect more industry. That part of the property is projected to stay the same, so the conditions, everything would stay in place as it was in 2016. All this does is change the OP. But that was a different developer, a different floor plan, but it was a multi-story building, and it actually attached to the existing office building that's there now.
So the straight line on the back property line is good to build apartments right now. We're just really looking at the C, if you will.
Correct.
Okay.
That left side to the left of the thin line is currently RP conditional. The right side is what's changing.
Correct.
And there's no need to carry the conditions forward with it because those conditions pertain to the Tomb Street side of the property. It just keeps it simple that way.
So the parking shown here is sufficient for the apartments, and then if they develop any of these future development areas, they will have to have their own parking for whatever building.
Correct. It's sufficient for the apartments plus a few extra, but any significant development on these other parcels, so they would have to be self-contained. They may seek a planned development proposal of mixed use for the whole site. Since this is sort of a specialty apartment building geared toward residents for South Georgia Medical Center and BSU North Campus, in terms of nighttime versus daytime parking demands, there we don't know that. One advantage of doing the residential part first is we get to see that in real data as to what is and what isn't. But yes, the apartment building of 117 dwelling units with this many bedrooms does constrain a lot of the property, limits the amount of office that can be put unless we start going vertical with the parking. Remember 15 years ago, part of the proposal was a 5-level parking bay. And that's still a possibility. It's just, it's too early to get into that part of the uses. But yes, you're right. Anything extra beyond this is going to have to support itself.
Any other questions or comments from the commission or staff? Given that, we will now enter into the public hearing portion of this case. Is there anyone here this evening who would wish to speak in favor of this case? Please step forward, state your name clearly, and give your address for the record.
Clayton Milligan, 3998 Inner Perimeter Road, Austin, Georgia. I'm here to speak on behalf of True North. We were the civil engineers on the design. Matt's done a wonderful job covering what the proposed improvements are, and I'd be happy to answer any further questions you have from regards to the site.
There's no questions. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Miller. Is there anyone else here who would like to speak in favor of this case? Is there anyone here who would like to speak against this case this evening? If so, please come forward and state your name and address. Thank you. That closes the public hearing section for this case. I'll now entertain a motion from the commissioners, if there is one.
Make a motion. Commissioner Miller. Regarding file number VA-2021-18, I make a motion for approval.
First ask.
For the rezoning.
For the rezoning.
Okay. Second. All right. There's a motion for approval from Commissioner Miller on the rezoning. rezoning, and been seconded by Commissioner Wiles. All those in favor of the motion, please raise your right hand. Those against?